Hi YouTube, so today is going to be an updated foundation routine and I really have changed like my whole foundation routine since my previous video. So I thought it was time to show you guys what I use. So just a few facts about my skin and my skincare. I have combination oily skin. I am normal on my cheeks and oily on my T-zone, which I think a lot of us are. I'm really bad with taking care of my skin at the moment. I really want to get on it and start buying better products for my skin, but I'm not doing that yet, so I can't include that. Right now, all I do is I use a regular hand bar soap and I just rub it between my hands and I just clean off my makeup. I also do that in the morning right when I wake up before I put on my makeup. And that's all I really do. I just wash my face twice a day for like about a minute. The moisturizer that I use during the day is the Up and Up Facial Moisturizer Lotion SPF 15 oil-free. And this is, I think, the one comparable to the Neutrogena oil-free one. I like this moisturizer quite a bit. It's very lightweight. I don't love it just because sometimes I feel like I need a little bit more moisture, but for daily use, it's pretty good. And then what really keeps my skin hydrated is what I use at night, and I use Pond's Dry Skin Cream. I really don't like to use this for day moisturizer because I feel like it's just a little bit too oily. Like, right when I put this on, I can feel like the oils start to moisturize my face, and that's why I use it only at night before I go to bed. On days when I'm really dry, I just put on a lot of this and I wake up in the morning and my dryness is gone. So I would really recommend Pond's if you have dryness problems. Just like put on a layer of this at night and you will wake up in the morning and your dryness will probably most likely be gone. So I hardly do any touch-ups during the day. Actually, I don't do any touch-ups during the day. I just blot my face like once a day, and the blotting sheets that I use are e.l.f. Dollar Line one, and these are just perfect. It comes with 50, so you're paying like 2 cents for a sheet, and these are just absolutely amazing. They do the job very cheap compared to other blotting sheets, which are like $5 or over. So the current foundation that I use is the Revlon Colorstay Whipped, and I am in the shade 320 Warm Golden. And first off, I love this foundation. This is like everything I've wanted in a foundation. It lasts all day, it's almost a perfect match, it's medium coverage, and it's very lightweight. So it comes in a little jar and it's almost like a cream consistency, but it's very lightweight. It's not heavy on your face at all. My roommate has the regular Revlon Colorstay liquid foundation and she says this is a lot lighter than the liquid. This really helps me stay like mostly oil-free throughout the day. The only complaint I have about this foundation is that when I do begin to get oily, I feel like my foundation gets a little bit tacky. Nothing that a blotting sheet can't get rid of, but I just thought I'd let you guys know. If you've seen other reviews of this foundation, you will know that the longer you wear it, the better it looks, and I definitely agree with that. People say that it can be full coverage, but I don't really agree with that. When I put on a second layer, I feel like it doesn't really do anything for me. Maybe because I don't have too much to cover, but I feel like it's like just a medium coverage foundation. My redness does tend to peep a little bit at the end of the day, but it's nothing major. And I'm like halfway through it and I've been using it for almost 2 months, so I feel like maybe it might not last that long, but it's fine because I used to use the Smashbox BB cream, which was like 40 bucks, and this is definitely like a better deal. So people say that you can't apply this with a brush, but I find that with a regular foundation brush it works perfectly fine. But the only thing is that I think with your fingers, you just use a lot less product. And that's like the only difference I can see from using a brush and my fingers. Sometimes I get stuck on a product and it's just really hard for me to let it go. And I think this foundation is like one of those things. So the concealer that I use right now is the Revlon Colorstay in the color Light Medium. I have tried this without foundation and powder and it works perfectly fine. It does stay on all day. For the coverage, I would say it's also like a medium coverage. It definitely covers up what I need it to, but because it's like a liquid formula, it's not full coverage. So would I recommend it? Yes, I would. So this is how my skin looks like without any foundation. I don't know if the camera would show all my discoloration, but I definitely have redness around my nose, and then I have a lot of like discoloration and scarring on my chin, around my nose, especially up here on my nose bridge, because I do wear glasses at night and it makes like marks up here, which is like hard to conceal. And I have a little bit of under eyes, but not too much, nothing that I really need to worry about. And then of course I have freckles, and the middle of my face just tends to be a lot wider than the outside, and my skin's just not really that even. I don't really have too much problems with breakout, and so I really don't have to deal with that too much, which I am pretty glad of. So for the application of my foundation, I just use my fingers, and I don't know if you can tell, but I'm kind of like pretty deep into this pot. I just tend to start on my chin. And of course, you want to start off with clean fingers. And then I just rub it in. Oh, I guess I can skip the concealer part, but because I did purchase a concealer and I do want to use it up, I'm currently using the Revlon ColorStay Concealer in the color light medium. And I just really concentrate on areas where I feel like the foundation tends to wear off during the day. And that will be under my eyes, around my nose, around my mouth. And then I have like a pimple scarring up here somewhere. I can't really even see in the viewfinder. But I just dot it right here too. And so I just blend that. And that's really all there is to my foundation routine. I don't even powder anymore because with the Revlon ColorStay Whips, it's really needless to powder. It dries to like almost a matte finish. And so when I add like a powder over it, I just feel like it looks a little bit too matte and powdered. So that's all to my current foundation slash skincare routine. I am really sorry if it wasn't what you expected. I know I need to take care of my skin a lot better, but it's just a little difficult for me right now just because I'm like almost 22 and my skincare is pretty set, but I do want to change it up a little bit because I am getting older and I do want to prevent wrinkles and all that other bad skin stuff. So if you have any good recommendations for skincare, please put it down in the info box down below. And I will see you guys in my next video.